Mr. Logic from Houston, Texas. A big item on Diva Dirt this past week was about who should be the next diva entered into the WWE Hall of Fame. There were two recurring arguments made by a lot of people. Number one, Mildred Burke should be in next, which is a good call in my book. The other argument is that Chyna will likely not go in simply because she acted in adult films, which sounds like BS in my book. Is there credence that her work in porn is something that could keep her out of the Hall of Fame? Do you think Chyna should even go into the Hall of Fame? What other divas do you see being inducted in the near future? To go back to your Mildred Burke point, Mildred Burke was a big name in women's wrestling. I think she retired in the 1950s, so that tells you how far back she goes. She hasn't exactly been a recent name that people would know, and I think she passed away in the late 80s. There's no way I don't think Mildred Burke goes into the WWE Hall of Fame unless it's done very quietly at some point in the future. And if for no other reason, number one, she's a name nobody would know. And as we know, because Jerry Lawler wanted Lance Russell to induct him into the Hall of Fame, and that's when he got the classic answer from Kevin Dunn. Well, nobody knows who Lance Russell is, so we'll go with William Shatner instead. Fuck you, Kevin Dunn. But anyway, but people don't know Mildred Burke, but also they don't have any footage of her. And it's hard to put somebody in the Hall of Fame when you can't even put a video package together to show people who this woman is. So I think that, coupled with the fact that her name just goes back so far in the past, and there obviously is no affiliation at all to WWE, I don't see her going in. Not to say she doesn't deserve it, but she's not going in. Chyna. Do I think Chyna is going to go in? Do I think she deserves to go in? I do. I think Chyna probably deserves to go in as part of a package induction for DX. If they're ever going to induct DX as a group, which I think they probably will, they'll probably induct the NWO at some point, then I think she should go in as her, Triple H, and Shawn should go in. And I guess if you want to throw the Outlaws in there, you can do that too. But that's how I would see her going in. I say, why not? I mean, look, you know, say what you want to about Chyna. She certainly left a mark. She did things that no other diva before her had ever done. She wrestled the men. She was an Intercontinental Champion, which I thought was a disgrace, but they did it. She did something nobody else has done since and probably never will again. And back in the day when Chyna first came in those first few years, before the very end there, I mean, she was a force to be reckoned with on that TV show. And she was over, and she was a badass woman who, whether you were male or female, would go and just kick your ass. So Chyna was a big part of that whole Attitude Era period that everybody loves to romanticize about. Yeah, I think she probably does deserve a spot in the Hall of Fame. And I don't think... Here's the thing. I don't think her past in porn would prevent her from going in. What will prevent her from going in is the fact that I think she's still involved in porn or, like, escorts or... I don't know what she's doing in her day-to-day life, but I think she's still part of that world. As long as she's part of that world and still doing adult stuff, she's not going in. She would have to get away from that, retire, whatever the word is, and be a few years removed from all that and stay out of trouble and kind of keep her nose clean, and then I think she would go in. As long as she's still involved in the adult world in some way, shape, or form, she ain't going in. It's just not going to happen. As far as what divas I see being inducted in the near future, I thought about this. I came up with three names that I could easily see going in. The first one is Sable. And I say that because Sable, of course, is married to Brock Lesnar. So she's on at least amicable terms with the company. She has to be. And she also made a mark. Now, she may not have been very well liked by people. There's a lot of stories about her acting like a diva behind the scenes and being difficult to work with. And Sean Waltman taking a dump in her bag one day, which is just lovely. Just a lovely visual. But she was a former women's champion. She was one of the big stars of the Attitude Era. She was on the cover of Playboy, which sold, I think, like a record number of copies for Playboy at the time. She was a draw. Sable was a draw. You know, when Mark Merrow went down with that knee injury and his wife was on TV more than he was and got over as a star, he came back and, I mean, there was no way. I mean, she just completely dwarfed him in terms of star power. And from there, she only got bigger and bigger. And her chest got bigger and bigger. So Sable going in, given the Brock Lesnar connection, I could see that. I could see them honoring her with an induction. Mickey James is another one. She's no longer affiliated with TNA. I guess she's married. She's not married, but she's with Magnus, I think, and they're having a kid. I don't think that would have any real impact on things. I know they brought Mickie James in to do some work one week many, many, many months ago with the Divas down in at the Performance Center. And there was some talk that she was going to debut on Raw, and she never did. So obviously she's on good terms with the company. As long as she's completely gone from TNA and isn't really affiliated with any other wrestling organization, I think there's always a good chance that she goes in. She was one of their more memorable performers, and she's a great wrestler. She would deserve it. And Victoria is another one, the former Tara from TNA. Also, she's gone from the company. She's doing her own thing, running her own business, I think, in Chicago. She was just visiting recently, I think, backstage at a Raw show. She's very friendly with the people who work there. And, we have, you know, people have a lot of respect for her. She's a great wrestler. And she held the women's title a bunch of times and had success. So Sable, Mickie James, and Victoria, not necessarily in that order. I think those are three names that probably are on their way into the Hall of Fame next as far as the women go.